Valentine's is a day associated with love and affection, but for Magdalene James, the day will forever be a source of horror, pain, and grief. That was the day her son, Dwayne Chubby James, was murdered. The recent memory of his death has again reminded her of what she says is the snail pace of the local justice system.
On February 14, 2009, I received a call at 2:50. When I answered the phone, my daughter called me and told me my son was killed at Menard Hill. When I saw my son lying, you know, I just felt something just took me from the ground and just held me up in the air. And I couldn't say nothing, nothing at all. Just what I felt. I felt I was myself.
After years of the case being adjourned and a mistrial declared on May 4th, 2015, she says she is beyond frustrated with the entire episode.
I feel very bad and very sad about it. Very, very, very. Because every time I go to court, sometimes a whole month, every day I went there, they adjourned, tomorrow, come back tomorrow, tomorrow, tomorrow. I told myself. And to me, when I was in that courtroom there, I'm not myself. I'm shaky, I'm crying. My heart is not in place. I cannot even say how I feel and how I feel. But all I say to myself, judgment. I want a judgment for my son.
Jonathan St. Rose, also known as Ninja Dan, along with two other men, were charged for the murder of 31-year-old Dwayne Chubby James. The men are currently on remand at the Borderley Correctional Facility for the matter. St. Rose is among several inmates in the country who have been imprisoned for several years without being convicted. The European Union, after calling an unprecedented press conference on the island, expressed concern over the backlog of cases and excessive adjournments that lead to long delays. For the DBS News World, I am Sarah Peter.